Welcome to High Fine Stage Dives, a SoCan licensed podcast coming to you weekly from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Each week, I talk about a song that's been stuck in your head at one point or another, or stuff you've never heard before. Welcome to this musical journey. Hello again, and welcome back to High Fine Stage Dives. Today will be about a band called The Tea Party. Now, this band is effing amazing. They're Canadian, and they have influenced me in music in ways I can't even explain. Let me tell you about The Tea Party. I'll get into some stories and stuff later on, some crazy ones, some good ones. I've seen them live a bunch of times, so I know what they're about, and I've started at a really young age, so it was really rad. So they're originally from Windsor, Ontario, Canada. Ontario shares the border with Detroit somewhere, I believe it is. And the United, obviously we say we're the United States, but Niagara Falls. So yeah, Ontario. Some different people come out of Ontario, I'll tell you that much. And I'm speaking from experience. A few people I know and a few very close friends are from Ontario, and they're different. They have just a different thought process and a different way of doing life, I'll tell you that much. The genres: hard rock, progressive rock, industrial rock. I don't know about that too much, but experimental rock, world music. I'm definitely picking up the world music. The industrial rock, not so much. They're not... As soon as you say industrial, I go to, like, Ministry or Nine Inch Nails or some shit like that. Not Tea Party. Like, oh. And their .com is a crazy story, too. Okay. They started in the 90s until 2005, and then they had a breakup, and then they made up in 2011, and they're still going to today. They made it really huge in Australia for some reason. I don't know why, but they just... huge in Australia. They love them in Australia. I mean, we love them in Canada too, and I'm pretty sure in some of the states they did pretty well too, because they're a great band. Labels: they were Anthem and EMI. Associated acts: there's a band called Art of Decay. I checked them out. I don't mind them at all. And Crash Karma. Crash Karma is kind of like a Canadian supergroup, I think, if I remember correctly. Their website: theteaparty.com. That's a whole bunch of controversy in itself. But the band members: Jeff Martin, Stuart Chatwood, and Jeff Burrows. These guys are fucking amazing. Like, I've seen them live. I've seen them do what they do live, and it's not a joke. When I was younger, I got into a fight with a pretty super pretentious music nerd, I guess you could call him. He never played an instrument in his life, but he thought he knew everything about music there was to know about. I mean, in theory, he possibly could have. Like, I'd like to have the conversation with him now to see where he's at. Maybe he picked up an instrument and played it. I don't know. But he just didn't like Jeff Martin. He was, I think he was East Indian, I want to say, if I remember correctly. But I think that's why he didn't like them so much, because they have a lot of East Indian sounding music. I'll get into that. And like, like I said, they're from Canada. Very bluesy, very progressive rock. Their blues thrown in with the weird drums and stuff is a really rad mix, I found. I think that's why I was drawn to them, because it was so different. It was amazing. This is a little breakdown blurby from the media, the mainstream media. The Tea Party is a Canadian rock band with blues, progressive rock, Indian, and Middle Eastern influences, dubbed by the media here Moroccan roll. Moroccan roll. Okay, so I've read this a million times on Moroccan roll, and I never put it together until I said it out loud. Moroccan roll. It's like rock and roll, but Moroccan roll. Oh my god. I know some of you are listening right now going, you're an idiot. Oh my goodness. Hey, this is my pretentious podcast. I get to talk about whatever I want. Oh my god. Anyways, so they released 8 albums. They do a couple of really rad covers. The song's called The Messenger, and that's a cover by Daniel Le... can't say his name. His name's Daniel. He's a French guy from Canada also. I can't say his last name without looking at it, because I have to see it to pronounce it. Also, they did a cover of Painted Black by the Rolling Stones. It's different. I like it. It's not like my first cover go-to, but it's good. Like, there's no way in hell I'd turn it off. Like, it's got the Tea Party Jeff Martin flavor to it, so it's pretty rad. If you guys haven't heard of the Tea Party before, or you only know some of like their newer stuff, I highly, highly, highly suggest you go check out all their back catalog, like all their stuff. It's fucking amazing. And if you ever get a chance to see these guys live, go do it. You will not be disappointed. Jeff Martin's a different dude. I kind of met him. I'll tell this story after the feature song. The feature song, which I'll be doing too, also Sun's Going Down. I picked that one not because it was the first song that I heard or not because it was like the one that stood out the most to me. It is my goddamn favorite song by them. It's like a weird like southern blues slide. It's fucking amazing. I love it. And the shit that he says in it, it's crazy too. And it's a great fucking song. So Sun's Going Down is the one that I'll be featuring. And I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I do, because I just hyped the shit out of it. But hey, it is honestly, it's fucking great. So the Tea Party released 8 albums on EMI Music Canada, selling over 2 million records worldwide, including 4 double platinum awards, 1 platinum award, and 4 gold albums in Canada, and achieving number 1 Canadian single from Heaven's Coming Down in 99. It's a great song, too. The Tea Party toured Canada on 21 occasions and Australia in 12 in November 2002. Like I said, man, these guys... After that, they broke up in 2005 due to creative differences, band members. Nevertheless, reunited in 2011 and played several Canadian tour dates. So the band decided to continue after a tour that they did. They did like a little comeback tour, and then they totally reformed. Then they released like a double live recording of their 2012 tour in Australia, a video shoot that they did on a live Blu-ray, and Jeff Martin went back and like remastered everything for like a total like surround sound. And I didn't know that, so now I'm gonna like go look for it and check it out, because I love high-end audio, hence the name Hi-Fi Stage Dives. I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna check it out, I'm gonna stick it on my surround system that I have, if I can find it, which I know I'll find it, but I'm gonna check it out. I love surround music, especially if he remixed it for straight surround. Like, that's a whole other thing. So the Tea Party was formed in 1990 by Jeff Martin, Stuart Chatwood, and Jeff Burrows after a marathon jam session at the Cherry Beach Rehearsal Studio in Toronto. So these guys, they knew each other since they were in their teenage years, and they played in a bunch of different bands separately and together, like In and Out. And they just decided to get together and have a huge jam session, and that was it. And they were the Tea Party. They got their name. It's funny. They got their name from the group The Tea Party, from the infamous hash sessions of the famous Beat Generation poets Allen Ginsberg, Jack Kerouac, and William Burroughs. Weird, Burroughs and Burroughs, but it's spelled totally different. And that's how they got their name. They're like those really like weird artsy smart people. I don't know. They're different. Like, Jeff Martin looks like a fucking pirate. It's weird, and he smells weird. And I'll get into that after, how I know how he smells weird. And then they released their debut album in 91, distributing it through their own label, Internal Disc, and was produced by Martin. That would go on, and he would basically produce every album thereafter. They have a very very specific sound, and Jeff Martin was able to produce it and make it happen. So in 93, the Tea Party signed with EMI Music Canada and released their first major recording, Splendor Soils. That's one of their, like, that's obviously one of the, I lie, that's not the first album I heard. Edges of Twilight, that was the very first album I heard from them. And then obviously I liked them and went back and checked out Splendor Soils. So Splendor Soils, very different. They do a lot of weird open tuning, weird like different tuning on their guitars and stuff, and they started using goblet drums, the dumbbeck, and created like an Indian sound styling, something like those Middle Eastern drums and stuff, and the way they did it was proper. And I think that's why that guy that I argued about music with didn't like Jeff Martin, didn't like the Tea Party, because he took their traditional style drums and stuff like that and threw it in there, which is fair, I guess. I mean, if you don't agree with something, you don't agree with something. I ain't gonna tell you how to live your life, bro. Obviously it continued on into their flavor of everything, and I like it, hence why I'm talking about it, and I say that every goddamn time. I probably will every time. So 94 album release in Australia with the single Save Me, launching the band's career in the country. So that song fucking blew them up in Australia, and the radio station Triple J played it and supported it and loved it, and it's their national radio station in Australia, enabling the band's first tour, with Save Me becoming a staple of their set list, obviously, because that song made them big out there. So like I said, The Edges of Twilight was recorded with like crazy, like different, so many, like an array of Indian and Middle Eastern instruments, and they kept going with it. Sister Awake like totally defines what Tea Party what and is going to sound like. So that's a good jump off point, I guess. Yeah, people are like, hey, go listen to Sister Awake, cause this is kind of what the band's about. So that's a great song. So in Sister Awake, in that whole Edges of Twilight album, they did 12 string guitars, sitar, sarod, and the harmonium and the goblet drum again. I got a huge list of like all the instruments that Jeff Martin can actually play and the other guys can play, and I'll break it all down. It's pretty nuts. I can honestly say that like after seeing them live a bunch of times and listening to their music, it really pushed me to open my personal limits to playing different types of music and different instruments. That's what made me start like trying to screw around on drums and play bass and play the piano and try being a DJ. The Edges of Twilight definitely was their most successful and most popular album. That what broke them through. It only sold, well, it exceeded 270,000 units. Then, not bad. Now it's obviously not very good numbers because we got Spotify and iTunes and Google and Player FM and whatever great thing you could find your podcasts on, such as this one. I'm on all those platforms, so just go check them out, like them and stuff. Have to throw that in there, just work. So yeah, after they returned from the tours in Canada, Europe, and Australia in 96, the Tea Party recorded, here we go with me pronouncing weird names, Halabra? Alahabra? Fuck, I can't say anything. And it's on an enhanced CD. Okay. An enhanced CD which featured acoustic recordings of songs. Now, for you that are listening that don't know what an enhanced CD, well, that was a fuckery of a time when I used to buy CDs back in the day. Because some of the CDs you wanted to play and you couldn't because you put them in your CD player in your fucking car. And if you had an aftermarket stereo in there, it would freak out because it started reading all the information that was on the fucking CD. So they would put like pictures, videos, special recordings that you can't get on albums and stuff like that. It was their version of it. But now because everything's digital, you get it all as a pack or you can get it off their website or whatever, right? So not the same anymore. And then, so Transmission came out in 97. So, okay, the album Transmission, after all their enhanced CD stuff, was kind of a weird. Transmission was a weird time in my life. I remember getting it and playing Mario Kart 64 and blasting the album just like as loud as I could because it was my birthday. And who was there? I want to say my ex-girlfriend was like a long time ago too. So 90s, I was only 17. I had a couple drinks. I was playing some video games. Oh yeah, my homies came over after now that I think about it. But yeah, I remember just blasting it. And I always equate that album to Mario Kart 64 because I played the shit of Mario Kart 64 and listened to that album Transmission. It fit for some reason. It was a great soundtrack to it. So that was released in 97. That's when they started getting into like sampling stuff and like electronica type shit. Around that time also, there was a big flow of EDM. That's when EDM started like coming out. Like the first incarnations of like real like EDM, where it was started and started to get like progressively more complicated and stuff like that. So. And I always like I'm listening to this, and I always thought Jeff Martin kind of sounded like Jim Morrison, but a lot of people thought he looked like him and sounded like him, and he hated being that. They called him the second or the reincarnation of Jim Morrison. So there's a song on the album Transmission. It's called Release. Great fucking song. It was about women's rights, basically. So what happened is Jeff Martin watched a documentary on the BBC, or a report, whatever the hell it was, about the state of women's rights in worldwide. And so he wrote a song, and it intended to be an apology for two women from men and boys. And it all went to the White Ribbon Campaign, and that's, I guess, a global movement to end male violence against women and girls, which is totally noble, and that's totally cool. So that was on Transmission. And it's a great song, too. That whole album is, like, really cool. It's, like, trippy and, like, it's got some nice synth in it and stuff like that. I love it. Then Triptych followed, like I said, in 99. The first single, Heaven Coming Down, rose to number one in the Canadian radio. And it's a great song. It was totally different from what... It shocked me because it was totally different from what I was used to listening to from the first few albums that were out. It was a lot more chill, more symphonic, and a little bit different. So later on, so... Come the year 2005, the band released a single compilation called The Tangents of the Tea Party Collection in 2000. That's where all their hits are, and it's a great best of. And then they were nominated for a Juno for Best Music Group. They released a DVD compilation. This is the one that I want to check out. They released a DVD compilation of music, which Martin remixed in surround sound called Illuminations. I want to check it out because Jeff Martin's got a great ear for stuff, and obviously his producing is really good. So for him to go and produce a surround sound album, You know it's going to be fucking good. It's going to have all those nice little nuances that you want to hear when you're listening to music, like an audio file would, right? The stuff you're looking for. So yeah, I got to go find that somewhere. I know I'll be able to find it. I'll just whatever. The Tea Party then released the Interzone Mantras later in 2001, and in November 2002 joined the Symphony Orchestras across Canada in adapting their live show. It's really different because the Tea Party is very symphonic to begin with and very different and bluesy and very fluid. It's different. It's worth checking out, though, definitely. I like it. It's just different. To be in the right mindset, I guess, to listen to it for myself. But then the Seven Circles. Band's final album was released in 2004. Good album, too. Then in October, I found that the Seven Circles was more like their old stuff, but a mix with a touch, like a sprinkle of flavor of their new stuff. It was a good mix. And then in October 2005, the Tea Party disbanded due to creative differences, with Martin abruptly announcing he was beginning a solo career. Jeff Martin's a very, very eccentric, weird dude. Afterwards, Chatwood stated on the band's forum that Jeff Burrows and myself are sincerely sorry for the way this was handled. As far as Jeff Burrows and myself were concerned, the band was taking an extended break. I'm going to get into the feature song. We are going to listen to Sun's Going Down. And like I said, the reason why I picked this song, it legit is just fucking awesome. It's just a badass motherfucking song. The groove, the fucking melodies, the lyrics, it's very southern blues. It's fucking awesome. And I was blown away when I heard it, to, you know, and knowing that they're Canadian. I'm just like, shit, this guy is good. This guy knows what he's doing. So it actually started me on, like, really trying to sing different too, and like singing melodies. So, but let's get into that. Like I said, this is Sun's Going Down. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I do. Sit back and enjoy it and, like, take it for it. It is, like, sometimes I catch myself doing that fucking super pretentious groove head nod fucking with all the beats and stuff. Okay, here it is. Sun's Going Down. Enjoy. Sit back. Relax. Take it for what it is. I woke up this morning. Someone was knocking at my door. I woke up this morning. Someone was knocking at my door. And I said, hello, sweet Satan. I believe it's time to go. Knocking at my door. So, that was Sun Going Down. I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed that song, because it was pretty prolific for myself. So, let's get into it. Last bit of the thing, and I'll start talking about my personal experience with Jeff Martin. A friend's possible personal experience with Jeff Martin. But we'll get into that. 2011, Facebook page was launched. That took a while. Scheduled a number of dates to play. They did it. This is pretty cool because I was like, what do musicians and rock stars do? You know, if they stop playing music and stuff like that, right? And I always said, I was like, well, maybe radio station or some shit like that. And that just happens to be exactly what Jeff Burrows does. So the following day, the local radio station K106.3 announced Sarnia Bayfest lineup, including the Tea Party, which was later confirmed by drummer Jeff Burrows on his radio show. That's really cool. I didn't know he had a radio show. I guess you got to do something, pay the bills, right? So Chatwood, after they broke up, Chatwood, can you continue? This is cool. I didn't know this. This is really rad. And Nerd Me is like, what the hell? Chatwood continued to compose The Prince of Persia video game soundtrack for Ubisoft in Montreal. I guess maybe he just kept fucking working there at the same time. And then Burroughs joined Rush's Geddy Lee, Alex Lifeson, as a drummer in On and Off Again project, The Big Dirty Band. That's pretty rad. So I'm not a huge Rush fan. I personally, but musically, these guys are nuts. So Geddy Lee and Alex Lifeson, those two guys are fucking bonkers. Geddy Lee does some crazy shit on bass and with his feet. So singing's not my flavor. Alex Lifeson can shred the shit out of guitar. No fucking problem. So, and then in 2008, Burroughs announced that Edwin from My Mother Earth, Mike Turner, and Amir Epson formed the band Crash Karma. Debuted in 2009. Not a bad band. They had some potential. They just never cut through, I guess. Jeff Martin moved to Ireland to record his whole album, Exile and the Kingdom, which was released in Canada and Australia, obviously, because he's going to fucking ride that pony. And then he toured parts of Europe, Canada, Australia, and released two live albums. It never really caught on. Jeff is weird. He did some weird shit. I think he's one of those guys where it has to be his way because that's how he sees it. And I kind of get he's like an artist where he sees something, he sees it in his mind, and if he can't get it across, he gets frustrated and freaks out, most likely. Or if somebody doesn't do it right, he loses his mind. So, and like I said earlier, the reunion in 2012, and then he announced it on the radio. Burroughs announced it on his radio station. In August, the band implied that they were going to be back together permanently. Martin said that we are the Tea Party, and we are here to stay, and we are never going away. And that year, during a show in Montreal, the band announced that they would hopefully record an album in 2012, and then they announced in 2013 on their website, the band convened in Australia to write and record the next chapter in the Tea Party saga. It's pretty rad. I can see why they went back to Australia. First of all, it's fucking beautiful there. Canada's weather can be hit and miss. Doesn't matter where you go. You go to the fucking, from the West Coast to the East Coast, you're getting some kind of weird fucking weather in Canada. That's just how it is. So I can understand why they went to fucking Australia. And then in 2016, they said they were going to, this is cool, a 30-date anniversary tour with the fourth album, Transmission, that was released 20 years ago. The tour began February 3rd. I could have went and seen this album, or this show. I should have went to see it. Like I said, I've seen them a bunch of times before. It would have been rad to see it. I thought they were just doing that album, but they did a bunch of other like hits, so I would have missed a bunch of good songs. I should have went. I don't regret that I missed it. I don't regret it very much in life, but that's besides the point. It's not whatever. I mean, if they come through again, I definitely go if I can. I think it was like on a Wednesday or something stupid like that, so that's why I wasn't like in a rush to go. Like I said though, I've seen them lots of times. I recommend you go see them. Like, there's no point in not going to see them because you're not going to be disappointed. If I knew that though, I probably maybe would have made an effort to go. I don't know. It's so close to the venue. It's like fucking just not far from here. It's like a fucking 10-minute drive. I should have went. I'm stupid sometimes. So I mentioned earlier. Actually, okay, let's get into Jeff Martin, and then I'll get to their website thing. The guys. So Jeff Martin, I was talking about how they play a bunch of instruments and stuff like that. So I got a list here of the stuff they actually play on the regular, and then it's listed as they're proficient in it, obviously. Jeff Martin's is pretty, well, so is Stuart Chatwood's, but let's say they're impressive. Jeff Martin, obviously, vocals, guitar, sitar, sador, the oud, banjo, mandolin, dumbek, hurdy-gurdy, good percussions, and a theremin. For those who know what a theremin is, good for you. For those who don't, I suggest you Google it. The cat can play a theremin. I'm not well, but there's like professional theremins. It's different. A theremin. T-H-E-R-E-M-I-N. It's a different thing. It makes weird noises. I kind of want to get one just to make some fucking weird noises. But Stuart Chatwood, bass, guitar, keyboard instruments. So not just a keyboard. So anything with like a keytar. So accordion? I wonder if you can play accordion. Pretty sure you can. Harmonium, percussions, obviously, mandolin, tambura, cello, lap steel guitar, and bass pedals. That's one thing that Geddy Lee plays crazy too, is bass pedals. And Jeff Burroughs, drum kit, percussion, djembe, goblet drums, and the tabla. So these guys aren't fucking, they're no joke. That's what I said, like, I was inspired to play different instruments. So, their website, theteaparty.com. So their website in 2011, Yahoo reported the political group associated with the Tea Party movement were trying to purchase the band's domain name. Stuart Chatwood said, "So much damage has been done to our name by the political movement that we are considering selling the domain." It's estimated that the band could have sold it for $1 million US. They never did it. The band purchased the domain in 93 and has since added the phrase "no politics, just rock and roll" to their website in order to distance themselves from political movement, which is fair. October 15, 2011, they will be exclusively listing the domain for sale on their online marketplace, and it just never sold. Maybe they were asking too much money for it. Who knows? So as promised, as always, I will get into my feelings, my experiences, with said band. This band is fucking amazing. Like I said throughout the whole thing, mad respect for them. Where to start? Let's start in the beginning. So the first stories and encounters that I said I had with the closest that I had with the Tea Party was a friend, the ex-girlfriend's friend, said that she had a house party. I think you can hear in the tone of my voice. I still don't believe it to this day. And that Jeff Martin came to her place and that he was playing music and blah, blah, blah. And he was looking for drugs. And back then, I guess they did a lot of drugs. So that's how they found it. Flash forward to, I don't know, maybe 5 to 10 years ago. No, not even 10. What am I talking about? I'd say about 6 years ago, 7 years ago. We were at a local bar here. Very popular bar. They played all sorts of music. And most of the towards the end of the night, it ended up being dance music, but whatever. We knew the owner, so that's why we frequented this place regularly, because it was good company. The bar was usually pretty decent, no fights and shit like that. It was decent for a super popular bar like that. It was decent for not having fights. I mean, obviously there was a fight every now and then, but whatever. One of the doormen was a security detail for like concerts and shit like that, and fucking Jeff Martin came to that bar. Why? I don't know. So I went up like, yo, I'm like, fuck you, Jeff Martin. He's like, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Like, something off of fucking Pirates of the Caribbean. It was fucking nuts. And he was shaking like fuck. I don't know. He was sketched out. It reminded me of a sketchy cat on crack. Like, he was coked out or whatever, and whatever drugs he was on. But he smelled weird. He smelled stale? I don't know how to explain. Even, so I was there with my cousin and my sister, and we're having some drinks and shit, like, because we knew the owners. We're partying with some friends and stuff, and my sister and I were like, holy fuck, that's Jeff Martin. So we were like, yo, fucking, you know, come have a drink with us, blah, 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 blah. He's like, yeah, it's good. I'm like, come on, man. He's like, well, I'm supposed to follow him, so he followed me, but fuck. He got picked up corner of the bar where he sat and had drinks all night. But he looked like Captain Morgan, fucking Johnny Depp pirate, Canadian ripoff. I don't know how to explain it. But he smelled like stale. I don't know how else to explain it. He smelled stale. Like, maybe he was just fucking road dirty. I don't know. And like I said before, I've seen them, like, fuck, I've seen a Tea Party so many goddamn times, and the shit they do on stage. I remember that we had this one music festival, and I came to the stadium, and there was three stages, sorry, and they were in the main stage, and he started bringing out like all these different percussion instruments and all these different instruments, and they started playing, and then other people from bands and stuff came out and they were playing with them. It was really rad. They had like a little jam session that really, at that point, really like solidified my thoughts of how good they were, how good they could be. So that was pretty rad. So later on when I got older, I went to, you know, I was having a couple drinks with this one guy at another establishment where a family friend had run the bar or whatever, and I was having drinks with this dude, and he's like, oh, music, yeah, blah, blah, blah. So I was you know, start talking about Tea Party. I'm like, yeah, I love the Tea Party. Tea Party's amazing, great music. He fucking lost his mind. Because this is the East Indian fella. And he's like, oh, fuck, Jeff Martin doesn't know. Fuck, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, well, do you play? He's like, oh, he kind of avoided this, the conversation. He was totally in love with my older sister, too. It was gross how in love with her he was. And he wasn't a good-looking dude. He was like a short, stumpy dude. He was a nice dude. My sister didn't like him either. Like, she kind of talked to him a little bit, and then she got to know him more, and she's like, no, because he was like super pretentious, and like he really thought his shit didn't stink. Like, this guy was like fucking on another planet of not smelling bad to himself. So I'm like, that's some of my stories about the Tea Party and where it's brought me in my lifetime. Like I said, if you never heard these guys before, please go check them out. They are so fucking good. I've been looking for vinyl of them, because I just bought a bunch of vinyl yesterday. I bought a Wicked Elvis number one hits. It's got it's got Elvis, all his hits on it. I think it's four vinyls on it. But two 30 Seconds to Mars albums. A lot of people don't like 30 Seconds to Mars, but like I said, I like them. If I like it, I listen to it. That's just how I am. I don't give a shit. I bought a Death Row compilation and... what was the other one? Oh, and Gemini by Macklemore. Like I said, I like a lot of different music. Obviously, I went from playing some crazy music and the music I listen to, and that's why I do this, because music makes me feel awesome. And I fucking love music, and music loves me, and we have an understanding together. If I could be with music forever, I would, as like a physical thing. Anyways, thank you guys for listening. As always and always will be, I'm your host, Ivan. of High Fine Stage Dives. The only time that I might not be your host is that if I get Alec to interview me one day, which I probably will do from the Awesome Hour, my other podcast, I think I'm going to get him to do that. I'll give him the, I'll like pick my band and I'll do my thing like I did with him. Hope to have him and Corbo on. I plan on having some like harder music too, some weirder music, some different music. You know how it goes. It's just, you get inspiration from where it comes from with music, right? So, like I said, and like I always say, and like I say in my drop, keep listening to music because it makes life that much better, and I'll catch you on the flip side. Thank you again for listening to Hi-Fi and Stage Dives. It means the world to me. I'm glad you could come on this journey with me, and we'll keep doing it every week. Subscribe, rate and review, all that good stuff, and keep listening to music because it only makes life better, and we'll see you on the flip side. Stay rad.